I cook up this job ad with a pinch of AI and a big scoop of After Effects. There are a few typography tricks hidden in there. Maybe you've already figured it out, maybe not. Either way, in this tutorial, I'll show you exactly how I built it. Hi, I'm Eran Stern. I'm a motion designer and educator with over 3 decades of experience, and every summer and early fall, work slows down for me. And even though I know it's coming, I still stress about it every time. So while browsing for gigs, I stumbled across a clever job ad on LinkedIn by Maxime Archambault. I hope I'm not destroying your name. It's in French, as you can see, but the design speaks a universal language, and that's what caught my eye. Now, I'm also a hobby DJ, which means I can't resist a good remix. So inspired by Maxime's work, I created my own version of this ad, tailor-made, well, for me. Who knows, maybe I'll even hire myself. Complicated? Definitely. Yeah, but this is me. So, that's the backstory. Now, let's get to the reason you are all here, learning how to pull it off in After Effects with a tiny help from AI. Now, no matter your motion design or AI level, I promise you'll walk away with some new skills and maybe even a fresh idea or two. So, what do you have to lose? Let's begin. The first step was creating the main robot character. Here's the prompt that I've used. A fun cartoonish character in the style of a classic Macintosh computer raises hand while he swings in its place. I tried this prompt in a few AI engines. Firefly, few tries there. Then Google Imagen 4, as well as ChatGPT. I've also tried it in Leonardo. Over there you can also use different engines. So I tried the Ideogram 3.0, as well as the latest and greatest Gemini 2.5 Flash, also known as Nano Banana. But no surprise, the best results came from MidJourney. Once I landed on a style I liked, I remixed it in a subtle mode, picked my favorite variation and animated using the loop mode, which is just great. This gave me 4 options, and I think this little guy won the role as my main character. Then I imported the clip into After Effects and placed it in a 4x5 composition, which is perfect for Instagram, even though it's probably the worst place to post a job ad. Still, resizing later is not a big issue. To isolate the robot, I duplicated the clip and used the Rotobrush tool. A couple of minutes later, and I had a clean cutout. So between those 2 clips, I sandwiched a recreated background from shape layers and additional frame. This way, this character can go outside of the frame. Back on the original layer, I will add a noise effect and I'll set it to 70%. Yes, that's heavy, but it helps fight social feed compression and also adds the gritty vibe I wanted for this ad. So this already looks cool, but now I think we're ready to add some titles. So for the titles, I use the Social Gothic from Adobe Fonts. And I love this appearance of this font. It mixes upper and lower case nicely. But for legibility, I think I'm going to convert everything to all capital letters. So here is a quick tip. You can double click on a text layer to select everything and then hit the secret hotkey combination, Control or Command Shift K. And this will convert all the characters to capital letters. So I'll repeat this for the word wanted as well. And next, let's animate it with a tracking animator. In this case, I'll set the tracking amount from 0 to 16, let's say over 2.5 seconds. And then back to 0 to create a loop. I'll select all keyframes and press F9 to create an easy ease, and I think it's good to go. To hint at After Effects and design, I added 4 tool icons from my thumbnail template tools. The link is down below if you want them. And in case you're going to grab this template, you're also going to support this channel. So thank you very much. So the pen and the stopwatch got a very simple back and forth rotations. But for the eye icon, let's apply something different. I'm going to look for the blinking opacity behavior and then apply it and set the frequency over here to 2 for faster blinking. And I think it looks cool. As for the target icon, I wanted a wiggle loop for the position property. So I'll isolate it by pressing P, of course, and then I'll option click on the stopwatch and I'll type in wiggle and inside the parentheses 1 and 40, and this should do the trick. However, when I preview it, as you can see, it's not looping seamlessly. We have an obvious jump at the end. So to fix that, I'll head over to aereference.com. Then I'll click on the expressions section and search for wiggle. And over here, I can copy this code for loop a wiggle. Paste it inside After Effects instead of my simple expression. And let's modify the frequency back to 1 and the amplitude to 40 as well. And this is very important, set the seconds to loop to 5, which is my comps duration. And now we have a seamless looping animation. Looks beautiful. And by the way, Chris's site is a goldmine for free After Effects resources, totally worth exploring. Link is down below. Okay, so far so good. The comp starts to look promising, but we are missing our call for action, or basically our main request, which is of course, make it move. So let me show you how I did it. Let's actually do it from scratch. First, I'll create a new text layer by pressing Command Shift Option T, and I'll type the title using the same font. This time I'll just hold down Shift to get capital letters. So the text is going to be make it move. I'll press return to accept the text, and then I'll set the size to 100 points, making sure the fill is going to be white and the stroke is going to get a red color, which is also going to be set to 3 points. I'll show you why in a moment. Now I'll convert the title to 3D, and then I'll switch to 2 views and set the left one to the left view. Makes sense, doesn't it? Well, let me show you why. Since I have a bit of experience with this, I know that I need to end this animation at around 4 seconds. So at this point, I'll set a keyframe for the position and change the Y value to 1200 and the Z to -850. Then I'll go back to the start and change the Y to 1600 and set the Z to 360. So now we have these 2 keyframes showing the path on the title, but we can't actually see it in the active camera view. To remedy this, I'll grab the pen tool and pull a lever, a handle, from one of the anchor path points. And then I can move it up to create a nice arc. Something like this will work. And now if I'll preview, we can see the 3D path that we created, basically driving the text animation in the main camera view. Now to exaggerate this, I'm also going to animate the scale of the text from, let's say, 20% at the start to 150% at the end. And now I can add the echo effect, which is the star of the show. And because I have some experience, I'm just going to give you the values that I came up with. So for the echo time, I'm setting it to -0.01. I'll set the number of echoes to 150. We can change it later if you want. And the decay is going to be set to 0.96. I'm also going to set the echo operator to composite in front, and now we can see all the red strokes accumulating one after the other. The title now swaps in a colorful echo trail. Looks lovely. Now, if I need, I can modify the path as well as the keyframes, making sure I won't see the main title at the start and the end until I'm happy with the look. Last step, the skill set icons. These icons are something that I'm using all the time, so I have several variations of them saved in my library. So I'll switch to the library's workspace. And from here, I can grab those white squares of those icons and drag them directly to this project. So all of them are coming as vector files, which means that I can now drag them to the composition. And then while they are still selected, I'll right click on one of them and select create, create shapes from vector layer. I can now select all the original vector illustrator files and just remove them so I have a cleaner composition. And next, I'm going to select all of these shapes and drag them down and then position the first and the last icons, in this case, the AE and the C4D, at the desired location in the comp viewer. And now I can reselect all the other application icons, return back to the default workspace. And over here, I can click on the align panel, make sure I can see the entire thing, and click on this icon to distribute all the layers so they are evenly spaced. To animate them quickly, I'll first press P to see only the position property, and then I'll right click and choose separate dimensions. Now, sometimes you need to redo this for the other layers, although they were selected. So let's just quickly do it. And the reason that I work this way is because I want to animate only the Y axis on one layer, and then I can copy and paste the same animation to all the other layers and use the quick offset command to cascade the timing. So I'll select the first icon, in this case, the AE icon, and animate the Y position over, let's say, 10 frames. Then I'll press F9 and make sure that I will modify those two keyframes using the graph editor. And I need to make sure that I'm working with the value and not the speed graph. So what I'm trying to do here is to create a nice overshoot animation, maybe something like this. Let's see. I'm just going to play with the graph until I'm happy. And I think that this is it. Now, I'll return back to the regular keyframes view and copy these two keyframes and paste them onto the other layers. I'll drill up everything and make sure nothing is selected. And then I need to rearrange the layers in the order that I want to stagger them. So I'll make sure they are appearing in the timeline the same way they are appearing in the comp viewer. Then I can select them in the same order. And now if I hold down Command and Option here on the Mac, Control and Alt on Windows, and wait for this little tiny icon, which is relatively new to After Effects 25.4 and higher, I can drag it to the right and everything is going to stagger automatically, which is just so much easier to achieve. So now I can preview the result, which looks great up to the point that the main title comes up and stay behind all of those icons. So to fix that, let's find the place that it clears out and then press Command Shift D, and this is going to split the layers. So I can now select all the split copies and move them under the main title. This should fix the problem. Much better, but not perfect yet. We also need to fade out those icons on the convergence point. So let's locate where this is happening. And I think over here, I'll create an opacity keyframe for all of them by pressing Option T. This will be Alt Shift T on Windows, and then change the opacity to 0 after, let's say, 10 frames or so. So I'll play with it until it looks good, which is now. And that's it. My finished motion designer job advert. Let's roll it full screen. So hopefully this catches someone's attention or at least earns me a like, a comment, or maybe even a subscribe. Not too much to ask, right? As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you picked up some useful tricks, and I'll see you again in the next one.